Hello, meticulous mommies. I'm back to do another video for you guys. This time I'm gonna do the next video in my extended planner series. This video, and don't mind the hair, I'm like 30-40 minutes away from washing it. After I do this video, actually, I'm gonna just wash this because it's actually looking pretty crazy. But anyway, I wanted to do the fourth video for you guys. This one is going to be my school planner. Yay! Now, I'm not exactly in school at this moment. No, of course not. But I will be going to school this coming fall. I have decided that I'm gonna go ahead and get everything finished and out of the way. There's only a few things that are keeping me from going, and I'm working on that right now, and this time in the summer. So, this is my planner. I just wanted to show you guys first. I love this thing. It's another one of my Target Dollar Spot revamps. I have just decked it out with scrapbooking paper and stickers and all kinds of stuff, and I love being able to do that, and I'm going to do a video for you guys so you can see how it is that I do this, because I swear, you don't have to go out and buy a KK or an Erin Condren, which Erin Condren's I really would like to try one, but I'm not really for the spiral bound planners. But I do love these. They only have 3 rings, but those 3 rings are really, really easy to, you know, maneuver with when you have a single hole punch like this, and you don't have the actual 6 punches for, like, you know, Filofax or, you know, Franklin Kobe. Yeah, that's the one. But I'm gonna go ahead and flip this around and show you guys my school planner. Stay down. School planner! Okay, so this is my planner. Now, I'm gonna explain, like I said before, it is a Target Dollar Spot binder. And I have just taken some scrapbooking paper, my favorite actually, because I love school, and I just wanted it to really pop for me, so I'd be encouraged to go to school. It's got a quote on it, it's got my name, it's got a picture of me from, it feels like a long time ago, like Once Upon a Time days. But yes, I love this planner. Just got a lot of different little stickers and graphics and stuff on it, different stuff. I even did this inside part here, because if you know about the Target Dollar Spot binders, they are completely plain, kind of like this background here. I put this here, but yeah, they're completely plain. So I decided to add a few extra elements to the front of my planners. It's just, there's a pocket here, and then there are some slits here, kind of like you would see in a Kiki K or a Franklin Covey, or, you know, just any normal planner. But I have also created a sort of pocket here. So let me turn this sideways, but I have the list pads here. I love these list pads, they're so pretty. But I took these and I cut like maybe 3 or 4 sheets of paper up, and I created this, which these are sticky notes that just I put in the pockets that I created for this. And these are those, these are adorable little hole protectors. And I thought those were, you know, appropriate for school. And then I just have this school sticky note, well, this sticky note that says school on it. And it just, it conceals my cards, because I have a school card, well, a school card for when you like get fast fun stuff, and then I have my college ID card. So it just houses those, so if, you know, I lose it or something, nobody will ever really able to nobody will be able to get to that stuff without knowing that it's there. And plus, in addition to that, I also have an extra pocket up here that I really don't have much in there except some stickers. So I created that because I wanted to have a bunch of places to keep stickers and sticky notes without having to really, you know, house them inside the planner itself. And then back here I also have some of these adorable sticky notes, or they're not sticky notes, they're page flags that I got from Daiso. I thought they were so cute and perfect for school, so yes, I love those. And these sticky notes were in the Target dollar bin as well at one point in time. And these apple sticky notes came from Daiso as well. I love these. These are perfect for school, of course. So, I'm going to go ahead and just dive in now. So moving right along, I've got this page protector for in front, so I can just throw in any sort of, you know, flyers or anything that come my way. And then I have this scrapbook paper, and I found this little girl in a magazine, and I just had to cut it out and put it here. And this is another Target Dollar Spot list pad page. And then this is it was housing a bunch of stickers, and this was the back of it, and I just decided to put it in here because it was so cute. And on the back of that, I just put some black construction paper, and I just wrote in some gel pens that I also got from the Target Dollar Spot, just what program I'm going to be in, well, a place for the counselor, what program I'm going to be in, and just information towards, you know, getting into school. And then I found this diploma sheet. I thought it was really cute. It was in a cookie bin that I bought from my local grocery store. And then I have the months all marked out. And up until now, this is all that I've really been doing in here, is just marking the days that have gone by. Gonna be starting school in August during the, you know, the fall season, but I do want to mark all the stuff leading up to it. This is a bulletin board that I've created out of scrapbook paper, same black paper, and then these sticky notes I got a long time ago. I think it was either from Dollar Tree or like Hobby Lobby or something. Now this came from the Target dollar bin. It was a $3 pack. It had these, it had stickers, and it had list pads. Not particularly this one, but one that was very similar to it. I found this one in a different list pad. It came along with these over here. I loved these page flags. Oh, they were so cute to me, and I absolutely had to get them because these sticky notes match this print that's on these list pads. And I showed you guys this in a Target haul that I did, but I am using them, so that is this was in the haul as well, but yes, I am using them, or will be using all of this stuff pretty soon. And this is the sticker. These are the stickers that came with this same kind of concept of flags and sticky notes all on one page from the Target dollar bin for $3, which I thought wasn't bad. Sorry guys, the sun's going down, so I decided to turn on my camera's light. So, next thing that I have is just some information that's kind of private. It's got my new school ID on there, and just, you know, some other random sticky notes that I plan on using for other purposes. And I will show you that on an update video when I do start using this. But you can see this, it doesn't matter. Okay, so next I just have financial aid focus information, just, you know, stuff to get ready for filling out my FAFSA forms. And then the next thing that I have, which in this start of this, is actually the beginning of my sections. These dividers came from the Target dollar spot, along with these calendar sheets.
which I have not started using because I want to start them once I start school, just to keep up with the basics as far as classes go and just different things like that. And the same thing for the weeklies. The weeklies right here. And I just wrote that in. Now the weeklies are the same, but I have been using them because I actually have a plethora since I bought like two of these packs. I wanted the dividers for a different planner, so I have two packs of these weeklies and monthlies, which the monthlies I'm using in the other one, but the weeklies I am not. So I actually can use these at any given time, and I've been using them to kind of map out how it is that I'm going to go ahead and go about getting in and registering. I've already registered. I just need to get the rest of the information for the school, and then I can go ahead and pick out my classes once they are up and available. So this next thing, I just have a couple of dividers here. I haven't figured out what I'm going to use those two for, but the next four dividers are for classes, and I have created a sort of a key for these already. Just each class is going to be a specific symbol, and when I do my monthly spread, I can just put the symbol instead of writing out the entire class. That way it's a little bit easier for me to just visually see, hey, I have, you know, that class today, or I have an assignment that day, or something like that. So I have the first class here because I want to be able to reuse these. So I can just put a sticky note here that says, you know, what class it is. Like, say it's psychology, I can just put a sticky note that says psychology. And this is another plastic sheet that just houses the syllabus for the class that I will be taking. And then I have these purple highlighter page flags, which I got from, I believe it was the Dollar Tree. But yes, they are see-through, and they're pretty much just totally plastic. And I thought it would be cool to use those for outlining certain important things on the syllabus, or, you know, on homework or something like that. So, and then there's just a couple of pink pages here that, you know, I can use for notes or whatever. And then this is the next class. And each class is a different color. This one is pink. This next class is yellow. And this next class in the back is green. So I have all of that focused on and mapped out. And then at the very end of this, this is something that I did. And before I explain this, I'm going to go ahead and show you the back. I just have some sticky notes, and this is another thing I created so that I can just slip stuff back here. Like, say for instance, I need another mini calendar, because that is what I had behind here before when I was using it. I had a mini calendar, you know, one of those little teensy monthly calendars that you can get from the dollar store, just, you know, for little stuff. I had one of those back here to keep track of other stuff like campus events and clubs and stuff like that. So I was able to stick it back here and kind of tape it down on this side, and I could just flip it open and look through it. It was really pretty cool, and I want to get another one. But right now it's just housing sticky notes. So I wanted to show you guys this because I will be taking history, and I'm actually kind of a history buff. I love history in itself, and I have just created a very extended list here of pages that I would like to mark all of history on. Not only from a scientific point of view, but from a religious point of view. The start of mankind, the Big Bang Theory, of course, for the scientific view, and of course there's Adam and Eve for the, you know, religious point of view. And so I will show you guys as I progress on this how it's coming along, but I thought it would be a cool idea since I mean, I love history. It's important to know history. So that is my planner, guys. And I'm sorry, I'm looking at my notes up here. I've got my work planner up here. It's just kind of giving me notes on what it is that I want to talk about for this school planner. So this actually is not the only binder I have when I go to school. It works for me and it's awesome and everything, but I do have a school bag that I carry, and that is it right there. Sorry about all the junk. That box, I have to go through it. It's just a bunch of paperwork that I need to go through for my boys' school and stuff. And then that bag is my it's my congregation bag. I take it. It has my Bible study stuff in it, and just that's what I take with me when I go to service. But this is my backpack, pretty much. It has my reading glasses on it. Well, my other pair of reading glasses. I have another one that's just tacked on the wall here. And then this is my binder. Now, this binder, I absolutely love the plaid. It spoke to me as soon as I saw it. And the plaid, it works for me. But when you open my binder up, I just have a whole bunch of different stuff. A kind of dashboard I made out of the front cover. Now this I got from Daiso, and I thought it was really, really cute. And I just stuck it in here with some tape on the back, double-sided tape. And then it just has these list pads that are just big old sticky notes. I thought it was so cool because it's kind of got that whole Alice in Wonderland theme to it. And then on the inside of this, which this actually came like this. You open it all the way up and it's got list pads. You know, they're sticky note list pads. And they stick really well. And then it has these cute sticky notes here. I thought these were cute. And then these are even cuter, a mirror, and then the cute little bird in its cage. And then I just stuck some sticky notes here. Well, not sticky note stuff. They're just dots, like market dots, that I can use to, you know, kind of really just flow in my binder. And I'll show you where I use them and how I use them. So that is that. That's what's in there, and I can just close that and it all stays put really good. And then I just have, you know, a cute little saying here, more sticky notes. And then I loved these. They were in the Target dollar spot, and I can just write down thoughts that I have during class, and after class I can go up to the teacher or the professor and, you know, just ask them the question. And then I've got these little stickies that came with this. And, you know, I can use them for various other things. Now, I saw this in, I don't know if it was Walmart or the Target Dollars. No, it wasn't the Target Dollars spot. I think it was Walmart or, like, Dollar General or something. And it is the cutest pen pack. I don't have any pens in here right now. But look at that. It's like, you open it up and it's a monster. And it's just so darn cute. I thought it was just adorable, so I had to have it for school. So, the next thing I have is just my dividers, which these dividers came from the Target dollar bin. Once again, I love the Target dollar bin. And if you look over here, I just have the dots on each divider. Now, the reason why I do this is because when I write out notes or anything, and I already emptied out my binder of all my previous, you know, school stuff. When I look in my planner, I can just use the dot to symbolize where the notes are. The dot shows me, you know, hey, this is in file, I mean, under the divider that has the red dot. Because as you saw in my planner, I didn't have actual dots. Well, I'm sorry. I didn't have dividers that flowed with the same thing, because let's say I had yellow sticky flags in here, but I'm going to be using the yellow divider for that class specifically. I have blue here, but I didn't have a blue class in here. I did have green and I did have pink, but I don't have pink there, so pink will end up being red. You know, you kind of get what I'm trying to say here. So I've got graph paper, the really good graph paper that has, you know, the five stars double sealed. It's like plastic right here, and then it's, you know, graph paper here. I love this graph paper. It's great to work on, especially with math. And I just have a ton of different kinds of paper and stuff in here. So that is my binder, guys. Oops, I dropped something. But I absolutely love this bread. It's so cute. It makes me want to just look at it forever. But that is my binder, and that is my planner that I will be using for school. In addition to that, guys, I will be doing a what's in my backpack video, because I have other stuff in this bag, and a lot of it is really cool, and a lot of it, you know, I've kind of just adjusted and then, you know, kind of made it work for me. So I'm gonna go ahead and let you guys go, because I'm making a mess just trying to keep everything together and just show you everything. But I enjoy doing this video for you guys, and I cannot wait to do the next video. I plan on doing a tutorial to show you guys how it is that I made the inside of this as well as the outside, so that you can go ahead and get your Target dollar bin binder and, you know, just go crazy and make it all cute and awesome. So I will talk to you guys the next time I do a video. Guys, it got dark quick, but, and as you can see, I put my hair up because it's getting on my nerves. But I'm gonna go ahead and let you guys go. So I hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope you come back and see me. Please like and subscribe. Bye, guys.